In the metals quadrant today, let's take a look at gold, which had a pretty solid technical breakout in that August gold futures contract. Gold was up about 1.1% on the highs, which came in at about 1786.10. On the lows, we were only down about 40, 45 basis points when we hit 1758.40 in that August contract. Now, talking about the breakout, we've been in a horizontal channel on gold really since about early April. Now, the high of that channel, technically, is really about 1770, 1771. It's not the ultimate highs that we saw in May and then again, I'm sorry, in April and then again in May. In April, we had a high of 1789. But that particular day, we had a pretty dramatic sell-off from that high. In May, we had a high of 1787.50. That was actually a negative day. So not only did we sell off from the highs, but we ended the day lower. Today's high at 1786.10 was close to where we settled. We really settled near the high, and it was a positive day. So overall, this breakout is pretty solid. Now, if you look at some of the other factors, we had James Bullard, who is the president of the St. Louis Fed, speak today. And he said he does not see an asset bubble in the U.S. economy. He also said that it turns out the pandemic was not as bad as people thought it was going to be, or as rather everybody thought it was going to be. So the economy is probably on slightly better footing than people had estimated. So this means the Fed is putting all of that money into the economy, and yet the economy is not going to be as bad, at least according to St. Louis Fed President James Bullard. So that brings about the conversation of inflation. If inflation were to come into play, people will start flocking into gold. We don't see it yet, but it could show up. We had some pretty good PMI numbers across the board in Germany, the UK, and the US this morning. And lastly, the dollar has resumed its downtrend. The dollar had a bunch of days up, about 5 or 6 days up in a row. It's now had 2 days consecutively lower. It's broken a very short-term trend line. So the dollar index is back on the back foot, selling off a little bit, which is bullish overall for gold.